welcome to the Comfy Red Couch. My name is Tracy and I'm your host. I am coming to you from another warm day in Toronto. The sun is peeking in and out. I have a feeling it might rain a little bit later today, but our grass definitely needs it. Although I think Isaac might prefer it not to rain because otherwise he might get sent home from work. Anyway, it is a gorgeous day. The sun has now come out full blast. And I am happy to have you join me on the Comfy Red Couch. I hope that you've had a fantastic week and that you are ready to just sit, relax, and check out all of the crafting that I have been up to. I have a finished object, I have some work in progresses, and I have some sneaky little things that made it into my house this week on brown paper packages as well. So excited to share that all with you. If you would like to find me, I am Tracy RR on Ravelry and I am at Comfy Red Couch on Instagram. I always love when you drop me a line, so feel free to do so. If you are new to the podcast, welcome. This is a podcast where I usually talk about knitting, although there is a little bit of chatter about sewing content today. And I've been making some masks, but I will get to making more, but I do have the materials now. Anyway, welcome. And I hope that you have a chance to sit down and enjoy the things that I'm going to share with you. And as always, if you are a returning viewer, welcome back. You know I always love having you join me on the Comfy Red Couch. There is plenty of space, and I'm so glad that you've joined me today. So grab a seat, grab your beverage of choice, your project of choice, and let's get chattering about knitting. It's now time for some tea time, and today, as I said, it's been hot. We've had a heat wave in Toronto. It's been, you know, in the 30s, but feeling like it's in the 40s. We do not have air conditioning in our house, so we have lots of fans, but sometimes that doesn't quite cut it. So sleeping has been a little bit difficult. So today I am drinking cold brew tea, and I believe this is Mrs. Claus's Prosecco. So it's like Christmas in July, and there is the loose tea all shaken up, shaken, not stirred. And that's what I am drinking today. Now, the thing about this bottle, when you've left it out for a few minutes, is that it gets all sweaty. So this will pop into the fridge between this segment and the next, so it doesn't get wet all over my table. But let me just quickly talk to you about my filter, my cold brew filter. This is a Hario cold brew filter. I have two of them because they are the best thing since sliced bread. They're better than sliced bread, in fact. And this is, you just put some spoonfuls of loose tea at the bottom, fill it up with water, and let's pop the lid off. And it looks like a nice wine glass. And inside, it's gonna be messy and just dripped on me, there is a little filter that stops the loose tea from getting into your cup or whatever you're drinking from, and you just pour it out. So it is a fabulous piece of equipment, or it's one of the best things I have in my kitchen. I absolutely love it, as I said. Anyway, that is my Hario cold brew. As I said, this is Mrs. Claus's Prosecco. And today, as I was saying about the cold brew filter sweats, and then I have a little tray that I put my drink on, and when I have a glass with ice in it or when I have my cold brew filter, it sweats and then the tray fills up with gross water, which I don't like, especially because I keep my needles and things, my scissors, easy access. I don't want them getting wet. However, my lovely swell bottle, it does not sweat. So it's great to put cold brew filter into here. It keeps it cold. It's pretty. This is one of my Liberty print ones. And I don't get water all over the place. So that's a good thing. Anyway, let us cheer to keeping things neat and tidy, even when maybe my brain isn't so neat and tidy. So to keeping things as neat and tidy as we can. Cheers. I believe this cold brew has a black tea as a base, so it's got a little bit of caffeine to it, which is probably a good way to start the day. I'm feeling a bit groggy today. So anyway, that is what I'm drinking, neat and tidy. What crafter? Oh, in my dreams, things are neat and tidy, but with crafting, sometimes it's a real challenge, especially when, you know, you're working on different projects and different mediums, sewing, knitting, just general. I did do some tidying this week and some moving of furniture, and it's slowly getting there, but I'll talk about that in bits and bobs. For now, let's get to my favorite things. And this week I've got a few things to choose from, and I'm just realizing that I left my finished object right there. I'm going to need to jump up and grab that. I looked over and noticed that one of my project bags was open, and I thought, why is that open? Oh, where's the project? It's over there. It's now over here on the comfy red couch. So this week I worked on three different projects, I believe. Yep. And the first one I am going to talk about was just a palette cleanser on Friday. I was feeling a little bit overwhelmed, and while I had been working on another project really, really well, and I probably should have just focused on it, my brain wasn't quite there, which is kind of funny because I was in the easy section of this project. But I wanted a bit of a palette cleanser, and I had been inspired by Jules, who is so sweet violet, and I made another wondrous dishcloth. So I have this whole big bag of lovely yarn. Now, Melina has told me how to say this properly. I had said sheepies before because it just sounds like that's maybe, you know, it's yarn. It is not sheepies. These are the katona. It is, I'm going to try and do this properly. Hope I've got it right, Melina. Shapeus. Shapeus, and it means little ships. Who would have thought? I would have thought it meant little sheeps, but no, it's little ships, and it's shapeus, I believe. So I have been using these little skeins of katona. Probably saying that wrong. Oh, these are just absolute adorable little jewels. They're just so beautiful and bright. And every once in a while, I look over at this bag staring at me and think, I've got to knit up this big bag of yarn into dishcloths. And slowly but surely, I will get there. So I chose out, and I've got the color right here. Now, these are numbered colors on the ball, yet when I ordered, they had names. And I ordered from a store in Saskatchewan, Canada, and I'm trying to remember the name of the store, and I'm going to need to look it up. The shop that I ordered all of this yarn from was Tay Mambo, which is a yarn shop in Saskatchewan, and of course I ordered it online because driving up to Saskatchewan one day isn't going to work from Toronto. So anyway, I ordered all of this gorgeous katona. And this one here is number 128, but on the website it is called Tyrian Purple, and it is this beautiful jewel purple. So I will pop that one back in. I've made one, and I have enough here to make a second, along with so many other gorgeous little balls of katona. So many. And I am using my sheepy bag to store my balls of my little face, my wondrous dishcloths in. Jules has a face cloth pattern too. Anyway, I made a dishcloth. So I started this on Friday, finished it yesterday, and the wondrous dishcloth is just a lovely little project that just, it's a great palette cleanser. It's a fun, quick, easy, just knit, fairly mindless, although apparently my brain wasn't fully intact because I did forget to do one of the rows of connecting, so it does have a little bit of a gap there, although the other ones are all in place. So every repeat, there's a repeat section, and every time you get a full repeat done, you then grab onto this side here so that it keeps your lovely little cloth together, not separating and moving all over. So this is one. It is a finished object, sort of. I mean, it is complete. It is finished. But I almost feel like when I'm doing some dishcloths that I want to do them as a set. So that's what I did for my lovely coworker for his birthday. I made him a lovely rainbow set. And I think that I'm just going to put this aside, not declare it a finished object yet, because I do want to add some more colors in there as well. And again, I'm going to do a rainbow with some Roigi B, and then I've got the V here. So that is something that I just sort of needed a little bit of a simple change, that palette cleanser. And here is my lovely little bag that I will use, oops, as I knock over the tripod, as I try to knit up all of my shapeless, gorgeous colors of Katona. I think I use that orange with that purple. I think this is going to be a very vibrant set, and maybe that, that blue's nice too. And I'm thinking, there's a jade in here somewhere. Oh, there's the jade. Maybe I'll use the jade because this is a very jewely. That purple and that jade, I think they belong together. But then there's that yellowy orange too. Oh, it was hard to narrow down my choices when I was on the Taimombo site. It really, really was. I may have gone a bit overboard because I look over there every once in a while and go, oh, I've got to knit so many wondrous dishcloths. And it is a lovely little pattern, but that's a lot of yarn. Anyway, for now, one wondrous dishcloth complete. At least five more to go because I think I'll do a grouping of six for this one. And this will be a gift, I think. At some point, I'll make myself some wondrous dishcloths. I also want to make Isaac some wondrous dishcloths for when he goes back to school in the fall. And let's move on to my next project. So it is now time to talk about the Stillness Mystery Knit Along Shawl. And I'm going to go back in the past a couple of weeks to Clue 3, which was released this past Thursday. My Stillness Shawl has been living in my lovely Firefly bag, and this is one of my bags by Awesome Granny. And let's see if I can just quickly share just the inside fabric of this. Is just a very simple but little fireflies inside. That's about the closest you'll see to the finished shawl at this point. I still have to sew in my ends. I did think about it this week, but maybe I think this upcoming week it's going to be a priority to get the end sewn in. And I've planted morning glories in the backyard on the lattice that I usually take photographs on. And those morning glories are really flying up there. So I really need to get this blocked and photographed quickly before the morning glories completely take over. Although I was kind of hoping there might be a couple of blooms so that when I photograph, it'll be, you know, picture perfect. But we will see. Anyway, let's go back in time to the Stillness Mystery Knit Along. Late last night, I finished Clue 3 of the Stillness Mystery Knit Along, and I am excited to share my progress so far. So my Stillness shawl is living in my Bags by Awesome Granny Firefly bag, and I'm going to quickly share my yarns with you. Color A is Golden Rainbow, and this is a beautiful one-of-a-kind from Lick Fadden Yarns, and it is a 50% merino, 50% silk blend, and it is just filled with gorgeous pastel rainbows. Color B is this gorgeous skein of spring grass, and this is a yarn by Louie and Lola Yarns, and this is 60% merino, 20% yak, and 20% silk. That's a beautiful tonal green. And then my color C is this lovely skein of blush. And this skein is also from Louie and Lola Yarns. And it is again the 60% merino, 20% yak, 20% silk blend. So those are my three colors that I am using. So let's get to what clue three looks like. So we had clue one, started at the top with color A, went through the striping, went through this little interesting pattern here, and then went back into the striping. Clue two was this lovely little lace section here, done with color A, and then back into some more striping with an eyelet in the middle of it. Clue three was all one color, and it was the gorgeous star pattern. And hopefully hold it so that you can see those little stars nicely. So all together now, my stillness shawl is slowly growing. So I'm not quite, my next row will be 60%, and then I will be on the way to the last two clues. So my stillness shawl so far is growing beautifully. I love how my colors are playing, and I am wondering if you can guess what might come next. Do you think it'll be more striping? Do you think it'll be another lace section? I wonder what you think. I will be starting that at some point today, and I'm hoping to have clue four done in the next couple of days so that I can film another little segment for a future podcast. And then I am hoping to finish clue five and bind off the shawl in time for the release date. So there is, if I can pick it up, my stillness shawl so far. And I hope you are enjoying the knit. I'm finding it to be really nice. It's got a nice balance of a little bit of thinking, but it's not too taxing. So I hope that you're finding that as well. So let's put my yarns and my shawl back in my awesome bag by Bags from Awesome Granny. And time to knit. So that was clue three of the Stillness Mystery Knit Along, and that is a pattern by Helen Stewart, who is Curious Handmade. I hope that you are enjoying your knitting so far. Clue three, only two more to go. It's amazing how quickly it does go by. Clue four, it'll be here before we know it. Anyway, let's move on to the next project that I'm going to talk about, and it's another mystery project. And I showed you some yarn for this project last week. I have decided on my yarn, I have wound up my yarn, and I have actually started knitting, and I am almost done sock one. This is living in my lovely little bird legs bag, traveling campers, going surfing, kayaking, all of that stuff. Stuff that I'm probably not going to do this summer. Anyway, this is the Handmade Sock Society pattern 6. This is the final pattern of the series, and last week I shared two different colors of yarn with you that I was debating between, And then I finally made my decision, and when I was putting buds away, I saw this other great skein of yarn called Spring, and it was ivory base, and it had shots of teal and blue, and then the mini was a nice sort of turquoise color. I almost changed my mind. But no, I went back and I stuck with Lily, which is this gorgeous ivory with pink and green and has highlights of this bright pink for my mini. So that is the color I ended up going with. It was the color I started off thinking I was probably going to go with, but I was thinking this might be a little bit too strong as a highlight. I'm actually really liking it as a highlight. It pops nicely. And as I'm knitting those little pink and green bits, oh, I do love pink and green. It is knitting up absolutely beautifully. So while Spring would have also been an amazing choice too, and I think both of those would have been better choices than Buds, because I think Buds, you need the little pop, I think, for this pattern. Although, you know, a nice subtle would be nice, but there's something about a pop. Anyway, this is the yarn that I chose. It is Nora George Yarns. It's a superset sock. It is one of the first skeins of Nora George that I did buy when I fell hard for Tracy's yarns. And yes, this is Lily and Minnie. And this pattern will be released on Tuesday, July 21st. And that's not too far from now. We are now at July 12th. So I am just in the foot of sock one and approaching the toe. So I will be finished sock one very, very soon, possibly tonight. And then I just need to pop sock two on the needles, knit away, and then I will have the final Handmade Sock Society pattern six all done. And then what will I do for the rest of the summer? Well, probably continue to tackle the whips, which I've actually been making some fairly good progress with. And that is the final thing I'm going to talk about today. I did say I had a finished object, and it has been living for 53 weeks. That's a year and a week in my Happy Homemaker bag. And this is my Chrysalis shawl. And I don't have much yarn left over to share with you. I have this little tiny bit, a little more than an arm's reach, maybe two arms length, of Ching fiber, and this is Merino single, sky blue. That's all I have left. And if I look very carefully on my knitting table at the ends I sewed in, I have a couple little pieces of this, and this is just because I had ends to sew in, but I did run out of color A, which was my Surrey silk, and this was the melted Surrey. So Ching Fibers melted Surrey, and it is a Surrey silk blend. This was Miss Bim. Right now it just looks like a rat tail. It's not. It was gorgeous yarn to work with. And yeah, that was a very, very good use of my yarn. So this is the My Chrysalis shawl. As I said, I did run short. I then had to make some modifications to the pattern, but I am happy to say that, and let's put it so it's the right side, my Chrysalis shawl, whoops, is now done, and it is big. I talked a little bit yesterday about the shaping is a little bit sort of wonky at one end, and I did look at some other pictures, and it seems that it's not just me. So it does this weird little sort of bump and then goes along, and then I sort of straightened this edge a little differently than it should be. But yeah, it's just this little bump at the side is a little bit interesting. So, the black with those beautiful pink and blue highlights, that is Miss Bim in its full glory as compared to that little piece that I shared with you. As I said, I started this project a little over a year ago, and it was nice to finally finish it. And it's a lovely little project with alternating sections of an eyelet lace followed by some brioche. And this is the correct, this is the A side of the brioche with brioche, brioche, tomato, tomato. This is A, and then the B side is more of a highlight of the blue. So the great thing about this shawl is it can be worn either way, and only the person who knit it will probably ever be able to tell the person who's going to wear it, Isaac, which is the right side, because he won't care. And there is something nice about the blue highlights on this side of the wrong side of the shawl, but oh, this side is very nice and furry too. So it's a fun little wear. It's too hot to put it on though. It's just so hot. So I think I will avoid putting it on right now. But yes, this is the My Chrysalis shawl, and this is a pattern by Lavagna Patricella. I believe that's how you say it. And my modifications. So I was able to get the full repeat of the last section of brioche in, and then I was able to knit, and I've got it in my Ravelry notes, which where I ran out of my color A, which was my melted Surrey. And what I ended up doing, I could have cut my melted Surrey, but I actually just thought, oh, I'll just knit it double with the sky blue. Now, the problem is, when I ran out of yarn, I tried to do the full row. I didn't have enough, so then I backtracked. But I was on a wrong side when I ran out of yarn. I was just so close. So I ended up cutting sky blue and then joining it on the wrong side, because how else would I do it? And I knit the sky blue and the melted Surrey, the Miss Bim, together for this one row. And I think it was the first row of the eyelet pattern that I, or the second row of the eyelet pattern that I ran out. It may have also been the last row of the brioche. I can't remember. As I said, I put it in my Ravelry notes. And I had enough sky blue that I was able to just go back and do an eyelet row. And then I believe I did, after the eyelet row, one more row. And then I bound off using the Russian lace cast off. And it's kind of neat the way that it did bind off. It's got that nice little section of eyelets along the bottom. And I'm actually quite pleased with how it turned out. I wasn't sure how it was going to end. I was pretty sure I wasn't going to have enough yarn. And as you saw from my sky blue, there's no way I could have done even one more row. So I will be able to gift this to Isaac. He will have this finally for back to school, which was originally when I started knitting it for back to school last year. It's a year late, that's okay. He has a new shawl, which will help keep him warm this winter, because no matter how hot it is right now, there is bound to be absolutely freezing cold days coming up in the winter. So extremes for sure. Anyway, that is a project that I am very happy to declare a finished object. And now my whips are down to, I want to say 6. My boxy, my sky map. I am working on the socks. I didn't even bother putting the wondrous dishcloths in. I have my timely tulip sock 2 still to do. And then I am working on a twinkle twinkle blanket as well. I think I might be forgetting. Oh yes, and then I have my gathering driftwood wrap. So I think that's 6 projects. And I am just slowly trying to tackle each one. I think this week I would like to finish sock 2 of the timely tulip socks and declare those a finished object. Maybe for next week, we will try. And then the project after that is going to be to focus on my boxy. And will I cast something on in the meantime? It's possible, but I really would like to try and work down those whips a little bit more. So I'm sure there will be something else that goes in there by the time I get all 6 of those projects bound off. But for now, I am just happy to celebrate getting at least one of them done. It's now time for brown paper packages, and this week, not brown paper packages, but a white plastic bag. And I did get a few goodies this week. On, I believe, Monday, maybe it was Tuesday, I phoned a quilting store in Oshawa, which is about 45 minutes east of Toronto, to see whether or not they had something to go along with my machine, my new Janome, and they did. So they put it on hold for me. I made an appointment to go and pick it up, and that's because I was driving out on Tuesday night to make sure I was there early enough to take my mom to an appointment on Wednesday morning. And I will share with you what I purchased for my Janome. And I do love my Janome. It is a 4300, and this is an optic magnifier, and there are 3 of them in here. And what it is are these lenses. It's probably best just to share on the back. They are lenses that you attach to the machine, and then it's like wearing a pair of glasses, but the glasses are on your machine rather than on your face. I haven't tried them yet, so I'm hoping they work really well. But when I was researching which machines I wanted to get, this is one of the features that I really liked, was that you could attach this onto your machine, and then that gives you a nice clear view, because I'm sorry to say that my eyesight is definitely not as good as it used to be. And this past Tuesday, I did go to the optometrist, had them checked out. The prescriptions changed a little bit, but I should be fine in the glasses I have now. Glasses are so expensive. Anyway, Isaac needed new glasses. These will hopefully help while I am sewing. And there are 3 different lenses in here. There's a 20x, a 40x, and a 60x multiplier, I believe. And I just thought this would be a nice thing to have for my machine and definitely for my eyes. So they had this in stock. And when I called the woman, she seemed a bit confused. She said, no, that doesn't fit the machine. And I said, well, I watched this YouTube video, and that's what they showed how they attached it. And that's actually what made me buy this Janome. And this is a machine they carry as well. And so I sent her the YouTube video, and she sent me back an email saying, thank you so much. I didn't realize that that was one of the things. And yes, the part fits the 4300 as well. And then the day that I went to pick this up on Wednesday, the 4300 has now been discontinued. I did notice that there is a newer model, which is very similar to the 4300. It's, the next model up. But I am loving my machine, and I'm hoping that these little glasses on my machine will make me love it even more. The next thing I'm going to share with you is in the white plastic bag. And on Wednesday, I needed to take my mom to an appointment, and she lives near a little town called Bowmanville. So we were in the main area of Bowmanville. It's an old main street, beautiful old buildings, and throughout the years there have been lots of lovely little shops. One of the big ones that I used to go to, where I got my map of Disneyland framed, the In-Town Gallery, it has now closed, but there are still a few other nice shops there. The yarn store that had been in Bowmanville is no longer in Bowmanville. It's apparently moved to Orono. There is a lovely little British shop as well, and when I went in, they had no Marks & Spencer extra strong tea. However, they were apparently expecting a shipment that afternoon. I wasn't there in the afternoon, so I will definitely have to go back. But there is also a fabric store in Bowmanville, and it's behind a clothing store, and the clothing store was closed because of the pandemic, but the fabric store was open. So I went around back, and there was a person in line, and she had made an appointment, and when she went in, I said, "Is there any possibility I can make an appointment to come in?" She said, "Well, the other person's not here yet, so come on in." So they bumped me in, which was fantastic, and they had these gorgeous, they're not fat quarters, they're fat thirds, and I was able to buy quite a few of the fat thirds, so a little bit more fabric, and the price was, I think, fairly reasonable. And so here is the size I got. And of course, these are for making masks, because we now have, if you go into any store, indoor place in Ontario, you are required to wear a mask. And in the fall, I don't see the mask wearing ending anytime soon. So I am going to try and make a double-sided face mask, which I was watching an Instagram video by Grace the Babbler, who is Grace of Traveling Yarns, Babbles Traveling Yarns, and she has that great video on helical knitting as well, but she had like a double-sided mask tutorial and pointed out to a pattern, so I'm going to try and do that pattern and see what I think of that. And then there's another pattern that I was directed to that I would also like to try and make some of those masks as well. I'm trying to figure out which mask fits me the best. I don't find the Olsen mask is wonderful. I made a rainbow mask for Isaac, myself, and Nathaniel to go to our optometrist appointment the other day. And I had put I had put really thick elastic, and I had put it so that it would go around my entire head rather than just behind my ears. And I had a hard time sort of keeping it on. And so I don't find the Olsen mask fits my face as well. The other pattern that I had tried, where I had made a mask out of the bunny material and out of my Penny Arcade material, those ones seem to fit me nicely. So at least I know that pattern is fairly good for my face, but I do want to try a couple of other ones. And I think the double-sided mask that Grace had is very similar. And I want to try and make a couple without the pipe cleaner nose, because I find that kind of drives me a little bit nuts. Anyway, I picked up some gorgeous, gorgeous fabrics, and I'm going to start sharing with you. I bought some yellow. But the yellow goes really nicely with this adorable bicycle print and with the golden retriever. So that will be a really nice combo. This is another fun one. Some penguins and other animals, aardvarks, giraffes, cute. I did share this one with you. I tried to buy a few darker and more neutrals for my husband, who, he doesn't like the fun prints like I do, and he's definitely not going to wear flowers, but he might wear something like this. This one's fun, isn't it? And it goes kind of nicely, so that might be a nice double-sided. And the nice thing about being able to double-side is I can maybe put something I would like on one side, and then something he might like on the other, and, you know, so it's got some flowers. I also got some buzzing bees, but not just one buzzing bee. I got two buzzing bees. And speaking of bees, this one here is a fabric that says, be caring, be kind, be you, but the bee is spelled B-E-E. And again, it's sort of like a nice, oh, that shows up nicely on the camera. It's a nice sort of black with gray letters. And I thought this would go really nicely with this one, with the gold stars. But I also got, it's in here. Pretty sure, there it is. This one, same star pattern. That'll go nicely together. I think that's too much black. My husband might like it, but it is nice to have a little bit more of, it doesn't look terrible. So he might like that combination, but this combination is fun too. And let's also keep this out. I picked up these for Isaac, this one with the musical notes. And this will also go nicely with the stars. That one goes really nicely. And this might just be a little, I much prefer the one I just dropped on the ground. I much prefer this combo, I think. So those are some that I kept other people in mind, although I may use a little bit. And then I found this one. So some words. And it goes really well with these stripes. So that's definitely got to be a combo. And more yellow. Wanted some floral. I probably should have gone with more pink. And I do have a floral with some pink as well, right there. And of course, in the fall, you want those fun, how do you like them apples? I bought some dragon fabric. I'll probably send a few masks to my sister. Some cute hedgehog fabric. There's the pink. Just one. I think I need to go back. It's a bit dangerous. And then I have saved some of the ones I really, really love till the end. So there's this gorgeous white floral. It's got beautiful little butterflies in there, and it's just a beautiful, beautiful floral, and that will go nicely could go with one of those ones that I got like that. Oh, that's why. There's the green. There we go. I knew I got something that was very similar, so those two go really nicely together. And, which one do I share with you next? This one. And we're talking florals. This one, I absolutely love this one. And it also, I think, goes nicely with that. And this one here, I think. So lots of little flowers there. Very, very feminine masks. These are the ones for me. Oh, and then I absolutely love this fabric. It's going to make some really cute masks with the little birds and bird houses. And I absolutely, absolutely love this color blue. And then, of course, there's rabbits and geese and it's just very marshy, but that blue as the background is amazing. I may have gone a little bit crazy, but they were reasonably priced for a nice amount of fabric. And do you know how hard it has been for me to not wash these up and start working on these because I wanted to share them with you? It's been really challenging. So now that I have finally shared my big, huge load of fabric, I can now make some masks. And as I said, I'm going to try out two different patterns. One is going to be the reversible, and the other one is going to be one of those ones that is like a pocket. So it has a nose section and a chin section that is separated from the front section. So I saw a YouTube video that showed how to do it, and I just need to go back, watch the YouTube video to create the pattern pieces. But I am hoping to get to that this week with my new glasses for my my sewing machine. Not a computer. I've had enough computer time. And all these gorgeous, gorgeous fabrics are going to keep me busy for the next little while for sure. And that is all I have to share on brown paper packages. And it definitely is enough, isn't it? It's now time for Bits and Bobs, and this is my segment where I talk about anything and everything not necessarily knitting related, though I am going to just chatter away a little bit more about masks while I'm thinking about it. I did get the pattern that Grace the Babbler referred to on her Instagram TV episode where she made the mask, and the nice thing about that pattern, it's a reversible one, which allows a little bit of fun with the patterning, but it also has four different sizes. So it does have young child, older child, a teenager women's, and then a men's sizing. So I'm sure that Greg and Isaac will appreciate having that bigger size. I found with the Olsen mask, they did have a child size and they had an adult size, but I just found it was a little bit too big for me. So I'm excited to try a couple different styles of mask and figure out what I like best. And I like the idea of the reversible just because it allows me to really have fun with those fabrics that I've purchased. That will definitely keep me busy over the next little while as I prepare sets of masks for everybody in this household. Plus, I've also said that I'll make masks for some of my friends and co-workers and family members as well. So keeping busy, definitely keeping busy. This week was another sort of busy week where work was supposed to stop 2 weeks ago and I was supposed to be on holiday. The first week of the holiday was spent doing a lot of the stuff that we weren't able to finish before the end of the year. And this past week we had some other stuff that we needed to deal with. So I still haven't been able to fully disconnect from work. I think I'm finally almost there, but it's been a bit more of a challenge this year. So I'm slow, and I think that's part of why the Wondrous Dishcloth on Friday was just that I needed that palette cleanser. And even though I had had a fabulous time working on sock one of the sixth pattern of the Handmade Sock Society, I just needed something a little bit different to work on and quick. And at least the Wondrous Dishcloth, I think, was one of those sort of just needed to change the rhythm a little bit. So that was nice to do on Friday. This week on Monday, I don't remember Monday. Tuesday, we did go to the optometrist. And all of us got our eyes checked. Nathaniel's good. Isaac needed a prescription change. Mine are okay for now, although we did talk about maybe getting some more occupationals. And these ones here are my occupationals. And I love them. We went a couple of weeks ago and I got them tightened so they don't fall off my face anymore, which is fantastic, especially in those last couple of weeks of work. Every time I was working, they were falling off my face. So they do sit a little bit better on me now, which is great. The occupationals are great because it allows me to see about 5 feet around me, but beyond that, it's challenging. And then, of course, when I'm in the computer, I can, you know, see and read, and reading is kind of important. So we talked about these will be fine, especially going into the fall. We just don't know what things are going to look like. These will be fine for now. And then in January, February, I think that's when my insurance allows me to buy another pair of glasses. So I'll probably in the winter perhaps look at getting, and it depends where we're working. If we're working from home, these will be fine. If we're back to work, we talked about maybe getting an occupational that gives me a few more feet. So while this one maybe gives me 5, she said the ones that she has gives her about 8 feet, and that allows her to walk around without kind of feeling a bit off. And it was funny, she said that sometimes she goes at the end of the day, she's got these special ones now that are all enclosed around her because of COVID, so it's sort of like goggles she has. They look great. So I don't want goggles. I'm not going to get goggles. I just need some regular glasses. But she said that sometimes at the end of the day, she gets in her car and she doesn't use her glasses for driving, and neither do I. I need them really just to read and see little details now. But she got in her car, she says sometimes she gets in her car and then she realizes, oh, I'm not supposed to wear these, and then switches them over for her sunglasses or whatever. When we left the store where I was looking at these and purchased these, I don't know what, because I needed my glasses so I could see while we were in the store, while I was looking at fabrics. I wanted to take a look. I didn't buy any fabrics there. I got in the car and I just thought, I feel weird. And I started driving. I thought, it doesn't feel right. And I realized I still had these on. And because I had had my sunglasses in my bag. So I stopped at the stoplight before moving farther and switched them around. But yeah, it was funny. I never do that. And after having the conversation the day before with my optometrist, I did that. So anyway, I don't need new glasses quite yet. And there's no point getting them quite yet just because of the flux of the world. But at some point I will get another pair. I rely on those so much now because my eyes, it's nice not being on the computer all the time. Although I think I probably need to detox from my iPad. What else? Isaac started his job with the city on Sunday of last week. He did his training and then he did his first aid training on Wednesday. So he had expired and he needed to get it recerted. And we were trying to find, since he came home in March, I was looking around. I had him signed up for a first aid course in August, but I was able to get him in with a Red Cross first aid course somewhere in Toronto. And he was able to get that done. He did half of the activities online, so all of the book work that they would have done, and then they went in. He had a really good time with the course. He said there were 6 of them there, and there was a guy there who was really quite funny, he said, and the instructor was really funny too. So I'm glad he enjoyed that. And then Thursday morning, he was right back at the waiting pool, and he's working at one of the waiting pools he worked at 2 years ago, where he was there a lot. He did a lot of coverage there. And the other day, so he's now one of the main waiting pool guards at that park, where before he was moved around and he was a relief guard. He is now one of the full-time guards at that location. So a little quicker to get there than his previous job. And he's enjoying it again. He did say the water was a little bit murky the first little bit, but I guess maybe after they're using city water, but he said that when it was coming out, it was really kind of gross. And we'd had a big storm a couple days before, so maybe it was just the system. I have no idea. Anyway, he's been working away. Yesterday, he got sent home a little bit early because we did have rain in the afternoon. When he left, it started to rain lightly, but it's only when they have thunder and lightning or really, really heavy rain that they get sent home. So he was able to get in from 10:15 until probably about 4 o'clock. So he got a nice day in. He's already gone to work today. Scout is here getting her ears scratched, by the way, if you want to just give her a quick scratch. Anyway, so he is happy to be back with the city. He much prefers it over the grocery store job. And it's, you know, he's been with the city for a couple of years, so he does enjoy working with them as well. Nathaniel, he's still in bed. It's getting late. He's a little night owl, that kid. He was supposed to go to Algonquin Park with my parents, but he just wanted to come home. He wasn't feeling well earlier in the week, and I think it's because he wanted to come home and play Minecraft. But yeah, so he decided to forego Algonquin Park to stay home with Mom, Dad, and Isaac. And he did go to the wading pool with Greg on Friday afternoon. I wanted to go Thursday afternoon, and he just didn't really feel like it. And then Friday, I just felt so zonked. And I know when I'm tired, when I fall asleep on the couch. It was about noon and I needed to fall asleep on the couch. So I just didn't have the energy to get to the wading pool. So at some point I will go down and maybe do some knitting by the wading pool. Just stick my feet in the wading pool. It's just like a little saucer. And one day I'll get there and it'll be a nice sort of outing for sure. For now, though, trying to think if there's anything else. I'm just right now trying to take things day by day. Oh, I did say I was going to start, since my cheers was about, you know, neat and tidy. You want to come up? You snort. There. Scout has come up for a nice pet. What a nice cuddle. She's now sitting where all of the things had been before I shared them with you. I talked about neat and tidy during the cheers, and the past week I have slowly been doing a little bit of straightening, wanting to move some furniture around, and our main floor is fairly open concept. This area is a little bit more... You walk in the front door and you look over and this is all open. But when you walk in the front door, you see the eating area and the kitchen. And there had been a desk and the buffet in the middle, sort of delineating the two spaces, the entrance and the dining area. And my mom took the desk and then I moved the buffet from the middle of the room to the back of the house. And the reason it hadn't been there before was because there's a window there. And the buffet is a little bit taller, so it kind of cuts off the window a little bit. But I'm actually quite pleased. It really opens the space up. But there is definitely some tidying that still has to happen. When we moved the desk out, all of the books that had been on the desk and the printer that had been on the desk and all the papers that had been on the desk sort of were put on chairs and on countertops. And I need to go through all that. I do know where the printer is going to go. It's going to go on the server at the bottom where I keep my tea. And I just need to move and set that up. But yesterday when I was pushing the buffet, I kind of hurt my back a little bit. So I'll slowly get through things. But it did feel nice just coming down the stairs. And while I do love the buffet, and I did like how it, you know, it did sort of separate those spaces. It really did create that block, and it's nice that it just, you come down the stairs and it's open. But definitely need to make things a lot neater and tidier. I did go through the mudroom again yesterday, and I took all the bikes outside before the rain, mopped the floor again, put the bikes back in, and did a little bit there. I just need to straighten the other half of the mudroom. Isaac has been addicted to bicycles, so he's bought a couple of bicycles this summer, and they take up a lot of space in the mudroom, plus his scooter, Nathaniel's scooter, my bike's there. So while I do try to keep the mudroom tidy, it does get a little bit out of control. I need to also go through coats and shoes and boots and things like that, because those are the things that seem to accumulate in my house, and we need to maybe decide what fits, what doesn't fit, what do we wear, what don't we wear. I like jackets. I have a bit of a problem with jackets. I have a lovely rain jacket, and then I've got, you know, a light summer jacket, and I've got my winter jacket. I did put my winter jacket away. It's up in the cupboard upstairs. But I've got lots of light jackets that I really like, but I need to sort of edit my jacket wardrobe, perhaps. And then I have a couple other pieces of furniture I just want to move slightly, see if I can find a location I like better for them. I have a mannequin that is in front of me, and that's where I put the finished objects sometimes, and that's where I keep this during the week. I'm thinking of moving it over beside me, and there's a little table here that I'm thinking of moving elsewhere. Isaac took out all the DVDs and now needs to put them away. So there's lots of straightening that needs to happen around here. So over the next week, a little bit of knitting, a little bit of mask making. I should say a lot of straightening, but I'm trying to sort of take things day by day. These are the things that I chatter about in bits and bobs, I guess, or at least this week. Anyway, I think that's all I've got to share. Lots of straightening, lots and lots of straightening, but I am starting to get that feeling of a little bit more calm, especially once I have this area all the way I want it. I'll be really a little more zen. Anyway, I think that's all I've got to share on bits and bobs this week. Thank you so much for joining me on the Comfy Red Couch this week. I hope that you've had a chance to relax and refresh. As I have chattered on and on and on, I guess I did get some knitting in there, but I felt like I just chattered a little bit too much this week. Anyway, I am wishing you a wonderful week ahead, whatever that looks like for you, whether that's getting outside, getting into some sunshine, or even the rain. It's nice to get out in the rain, especially when you're in a bit of a drought. Or whether that is just sitting on your comfy couch and enjoying some craft time. Whatever your week, your dream week looks like ahead for you, I hope that that comes true. Have a wonderful week ahead, and I hope to see you next week on the Comfy Red Couch. Bye. I'm going to be making masks for quite some time. But look at all those great combinations that will go together, and I'll have fun making other combinations that maybe I wouldn't have thought of originally. I may be bad and go get some more because, as I said, they were very reasonably priced for the fabric, and they're such lovely quality fabrics too. They're nice thick, so I might get myself in some more trouble in the next little while.